again, our stream health is not as good as it usually is. It is down on the yellow and red like it is today compared to Oswego, which is in the green. But that's good all the way down once again. No icing as Niagara wins that one. Theo Cup, or excuse me, Chris Wands there to meet his man, Ryan Peters. Taken away now by Lemieux. Lemieux looking for a cross pass. Himself and race up the center of the ice with some speed. He's going to dump it in. The head is Zell. Zell just lets it go off the board to the field. Field and Lemieux meet. Field just comes back. That's hit in by Wands. Lemieux right up front taking a shot. Another shot just goes over the crossbar. He couldn't get a shot. Doesn't even hit Zell. He's going back in the stick of field in the far corner. Now it's Chapin. Chapin can't get a shot off. Now it's taken by Hazel. Chapin and Hazel going to the boards. Chapin holds on to it. He just wraps it around. Nick Nature stands at the blue line, taking away very clear. Now McNamara. McNamara takes a shot. Knock on the goal! CJ Walsh gets the deflection! 1-1, 15-14 remaining. McNamara is for first. I don't know if CJ Walsh got a stick on that. We'll have to wait for the official ruling here. CJ Walsh did talk to the referee. Maybe give it a corrector there. But either way, 15-14 in the period. Stephen State ties it up 1-1. Nick Nitzel gets that one after Michael Mute, excuse me, after Oscar Markey won. He was backhanded in. Romano takes a puck, and now it's in Kersel. Kersel over to Smoke. Over is the stop. No offside. As I had just thought today, it looks like he was trying to spin there. He was trying to try to pass, and now it looks like Simonek. Simonek moves it off, but that was not there. In the near corner now. Markey meeting his man. Into the first though. Shot from the point. Popped up front. Stick broken. Sickles flying. I guess they're not broken. Barely almost offside with Robert. Grabs it. He'll skate in for speed himself on the near corner. Matt Rafferty wraps it up and taps it up to himself. He's a state three men there to meet him. He'll help him block the puck. Now it's center ice. That's going to be Chris Terry. Chris Terry just dumps it in. He goes down. Now just dumping it to Martin Simonek. Chris Perry lost the puck after a poach and Kurt was in back there to meet him and just dumped it. And now it's going to be icing. Guillaume Herbert could not win it. Right there, Nashville was Noah Koenig. Noah Koenig just beats Herbert out for the icing call. Nick Nitro at the near side. Pelosi just holds onto it. Now Wands. Wands standing up. Goes over to Cup off the board. Cup goes diving. Now it's in center ice with Niagara once again on the stick of Kyle Clifford. Clifford just dumps it in. That's going to strike the field. Cup behind the board, over the Wands, and wraps it up the board together. But out to the stick of Clifford. He just kind of the pass. Now it's Dawson who does it in. He's hit hard by Clifford. Clifford. I'm not going to say his name in one sentence. And that's the one in the near corner. Great Lakers there to try to get it, but Clifford wins it. Brent Dawson leaves a hit on Clifford. Manning's bringing up himself and some ice. He just dumps it in. No icing called. CJ Walsh tried it there to win the race. He's there to block it off. Just takes it too far for a teammate. Niagara's going to hold on right in center, right in front. He mostly gets a pad or a stick on it. And now, it's going to go with CJ Walsh at center. DJ Walsh for a pass, backhands it up. Tries to back come to Nate Morgan, but instead, taking it, it's Daniel Smolka who just dumps it in. Now with Brett Dawson. Brett Dawson up to Nate Morgan. Nate Morgan's got two men in front of him. Can't get a shot off. Just fans on it, takes the dump instead. And that'll go onto the stick of David Hazel. Hazel looks for a backhand pass. Gives it to McNamara. David right in front. Shot! Just goes wide. Keeping right in the slot. Couldn't get the opportunity, the golden opportunity. The Bullets went ahead, 12-10 remaining in the period. 1-1 is the score between the Purple Eagles and the Lakers. Thanks to a Robert McNamara goal and a C.J. Walsh goal. Bill gives it up in the center to Crawford. Bill loses it. It's poked in by Mike Lemieux. And now wrapping it into Niagara. It goes all the way down. There's no icing. O'Neill has it, though. Tathan in center. Tathan skating with some speed himself. He's jumping and trying to get her around field. Dell gets the puck. Nell's going to be wrapped around once again with O'Neill. O'Neill's back, takes it in, stopped by Fish. Now Lemieux dumps it in, that goes right on the stick of Field. Field has it, he's going to get around Lemieux. He's going to try to get it himself. He gets it, he gains his own, off of his own shot, blocked it away by Colosi. That might have got a little wide if they hadn't picked Colosi. Now right up front, wraps around, Colosi hits the post. Oh, Field, shot, and it goes high and wide after the flight of the stick. Or the fucking shot here, it's like a full shot from Patrick Romano. The Niagara goal is officially given to Robert McNamara that happened earlier in the period. Still awaiting the confirmation of the speakers, if I missed it. RJ Smith is catching the ball. Bobby Basso tries to get the play ahead. He gets bumped off a little bit in the back with Top up the pass, so I can't hold the pass. I'm back on the sticky top after Niagara just tipped it in. Top backhands it. That's it. Well, now with Niagara over to Gibson Stewart. Vecchio looking for a pass. Vassar didn't need him. Vassar just puts it in now. A hit there between Vassar and Vecchio. Awesome lead hit. RJ Smith needs a hit. Now he's getting up against the speed. It's going to be Christian Guzman. Shot blocked away and held onto by Colosi. Ryan Peters waiting for a longer but what he did with the bomb. Colosi was under the primary rating in the period. Far circle is going to be $8 for a face off story to me. Rita State wins this one. Markle wins it. CK Walsh, he'll just dump it down all the way. No icing. Clipper gets there to beat him. Walsh gets there to beat him with a hit. And Clipper gives it right back to him. Now a big hit there. It goes from Markey onto Stockwell. Stockwell's a little slow to get up. So he's able to take possession. Coming in is Chris Perry. Stockwell goes down, trying to take out Chris Perry. Clipper is still on the ice. Time for Marchie. Marchie shot just goes wide. A little bit of a weaker shot there as he goes sliding with the board. Very physical game early on here. Shot just goes high from Lons. Over to Clifford, sticking in the far corner. Clifford comes to all high and wide, right into the hands of CJ Walsh. And just dumping in right into the Zika Zell. He's going to hold on as Mark and CJ Walsh. Clifford and Walsh going at it a little bit after the whistle. Clifford with a major ice disadvantage for Walsh. There after a couple pokes from the Sega State defense. O'Neill looking for a pass. He just did the high pass. Goes into the neutral zone. Neutral zone, excuse me, skating after it was Kyle McNamara. The way the race is given to Stewart, he comes all the way to the diamond. Absolutely, he catches it. Shot right into the test of velocity. He'll hold on. Shot comes from David Fish. That's a little bit of a confusion there. 8:57 remaining. He's still the 1-1 game. Bobby McNamara kicking the game. Some more time. He's going to get a just dump this down some time, good amount of time. Vecchio, he hits him hard, and it looks like that might be a boarding call. Vecchio is very slow to get up. Referee's arm is up. Vecchio is down. He's not getting up off his back. Referee's call guys are in no goal of a
that's just going to go into Sega Smoke with no contest. Lakers are going to go back to recover and try to stick with this one. 119 remaining in the first penalty, 130 now remaining on the second, 810 now remaining in the open period. Cup has it, he's going to hold at the end board, try to clear it, but meeting him there is Ryan Peters. Peters there, instead of taking away, it was Christopher Gesiewicz. That shot goes wide. Fish now with it at the blue line, far blue line. Now over to Hazlett. Hazlett quarterbacking this one up to Fish. Fish shot deflected high and wide. I think that might have hit Matro somewhere. 46 seconds remaining in that third penalty. The Martin Senior penalty. 22 remaining on the Bear penalty. 7:44 remaining in the third one. And the Lakers. O'Neill and CJ Wallace, the second unit for this 5-on-3 penalty kill. O'Neill has it. Shot blocked up in front. That shot came from Robert McNamara. He's right in front again, but poking away to the CBC defense field over to McNamara. McNamara. Field. Right in front, takes a shot. That's blocked away from the carry. Chris Carey goes all the way down. He's going to try to skate after him. Bell holds on. Chris Carey's got to get back fast, so it's not a 3-on-2. He gets back. And the guard boards now. He's going to be Robert McNamara. McNamara with Crawford. Crawford at the near corner. Crawford over to Thurso. Thurso gives it all the way over. Stockwell. First penalty is over. Simonek's getting out there fast. Right up in front, diving around to see the state out of field. It's point, field shot, and it's gloved down by Golosi. Keeping at center, McNamara, Mew on his wing, and center for the Purple Eagles is going to be Crystal David Gazzle. And the Wicks, the captain, gives it Hazlett. Hazlett up to Vecchio, who was hit by Guillaume Gervais from Cali, off top of the red line. We just dump it in, pass it in the far corner, no icing, as I said, as he had the red line game. Now it's Vecchio on the far line, taken now right in front, taken over, tries to give it to McNamara. Hazlett lays a stick out. Could have been a 2-1-0 wide open breakaway chance after the turnover. Wands losing the battle with the Wicks. Off the Oswego State offensive zone, Bobby Vesta at center along with David Fitch. Bobby Vesta, Fitch, Bobby Scott, Fitch with that one cleanly. Goes over to the state of Skips and Skips, goes all the way down. It's going to be icing if Walsh can win, but instead, winning the race is going to be Justin. Walsh could have used his long stride to beat him there.
Now it goes out to the stick. It looks like a Martin Simmons. I can Martin Simmons have to leave it off. Jossie now on the far corner. Nathan Morgan looks to pass to get anything off. Now the far board is going to be a little bit of an injured parrot. Behind the net with Niagara. Bouncer will lock his own goal. Hitting with Bobby Bass on the outside of Martin Simonek, who makes Zell make a save from the center ice. 4:20 now remaining in the period. Up into the center neutral zone. Patrick Manning. Manning just leaves it. Bass are now with it. Maybe Orton still just dump it in. Goes behind the goal header looking to pull off the end board. Brett Dawson there to try to pressure Smolka. Brett Dawson takes the puck. Now to Manning of Niagara. Manning gives it up to Kovtunov. Takes a shot into Wolsey. Holds on. 3:50 remaining in the period. Still 1-1 between the Lakers and the Purple Eagles. Thank you for joining us on YouTube Live. If you can say ACHA game versus Niagara University. There are any Niagara University fans that may be watching. I don't believe they do broadcast their games, but we thank you for joining us anyway. Smolka takes a shot from the blue line that's blocked away by Natural. Passing off his stock while the blue line below the field. Field with it once again the far boards, now with Stockwell. Stockwell tries to get it over the problem. That's the end up cut up on the wheel. Now trying to come with Markey. Got Matro. Matro takes the shot, but that goes well wide. Now with Chris Perry. Chris Perry up with Markey at the far corner. He gets it, wraps it back around to Matro. Matro looking for a pass now. Matro right in the slot is O'Neill, and that's blocked away. I don't know if he can hit Zell or not. Markey at the far side, looking for the back door, trying to get it on it. Thurston trying to get a shot, but that goes back to the end boards. Now on the stick again after getting the pass from Lyman. David Daniel Smolka offside. Lakers had to get back, couldn't take advantage of that turnover. That's going to go to the stick of Logan Field. Field races in the zone himself, no one there to help him. He falls down and now trying to get prepared. Gives it up to Marcelic. Marcelic back to Herbert. Herbert slap shot hits the glove right in front. Nothing doing for Brett Dawson. Henning is on field, just dumps it in. Wan's going to get there, but Wilson stops it. He'll leave it for Wans. Wans getting some speed. Tries to get it around his man. Can't with his back. Can't up to Marcelic. Marcelic can't get it to Herbert. So that's going to go now with Crawford of Niagara. CJ Walsh hits him a little bit. Can't get him off the puck, though. White in front. It's back at the blue line. Now David Hazlett. Hazlett just dumps it in. On the stick of Andrew Parrish. Parrish can't find it. Herbert tries to grab the puck. Can't hold on. Now it's at the near circle. And I guess I'm in the near corner. Right up in front. Just goes wide. Looks like he can get his pad on it. Brett Dawson has it in the far corner. Crawford leaves it off. Shot from the blue line. Hits the netting. That shot came from David Hazlett. In to another stick of Peters. He can't hold on. Meeting him there in from you. Using the stick with him. Logan Field and back of the blue line off shot. Glove down after a little bit of deflection, but the deflection was far enough away that it goes over the track. That shot came away. Came from Kyle Clifford. 1:18 now remaining in the period. Still 1-1 hockey game. Shot off. He almost got the leak. Go ahead, goal. Martin Simonek now with it, just dumps it back in off the stick of Chapin, but it stays in the neutral zone. Now with Martin Simonek again, 35 seconds remaining in the period. He sticks with his man to try to keep the forecheck going. McNamara wraps around, that's going to be an icing. Sean O'Neill is going to win the race with no competition. Gibson Stewart iced that one. So with 26, 21 seconds remaining,
the Lakers have an optimal face-off. We are certain Markey at center ice, Major is left, and Chris Perry is right, basically going to take top again easily. Markey wins it. Shot from Cup, hits the pad of Zell. Cup can't hold it in. Now Vecchio is going to have his own chance. Vecchio takes a shot, and that hits the pad, and it's blocked wide by Galossi. 4 seconds remaining in the opening period, 1-1 game. Steele Cup there, Perry trying to battle it out. 6 seconds remaining now. Gives the park corner, Chris Mons hold on to it. The 3 seconds remaining, he'll just jump into the neutral zone, and that'll do it for the first period. The one that goes over the head of Patrick Romano. That's a quick 20 minutes. 1-1 between the team of ACHA Niagara University. Robert McNamara gets the Niagara University. We'll have to see who gets an official assistant during the intermission. That'll just about do it for the first period. Shots on goal unofficially 11-7 for an advantage of Niagara University. Like I said, 1-1 is your score between the Niagara University Purple Eagles and the Oswego State Lakers. We'll be back in about, let's say, 10 minutes for the second period. And some more play-by-play and some more action for the Lakers to come take the lead. But we got Oswego State 1, Niagara University 1. I'm Ben Carrico. We'll be back momentarily on YouTube Live. Welcome back to the live from the Google State ACHA. We're going to live life until the ice began for the next period. The State and Niagara University tied at 1 after a Robert McNamara goal for the first Eagles early in the period, as well as a CJ Walsh tying goal. Later in the period, after his tent right in front, I don't know who the shot came from. I don't know where the shot came from. But either way, it is 1-1 between Oswego State and Niagara. As I said, Oswego State in sixth place in the NECHL and fifth. So a lot on the line for both teams here. About 40 seconds until the team hits the ice. Niagara is coming out now. Lakers taking their time to get out and ready. Starting the second period here, next 20 minutes, the middle period. Now that it is seconds to open up this period, but it's going to be the Oswego State zone. Looking to pull in some momentum on their side. Zone line changes. They're going on a quick 6-second shift. Marky wins that one again. That was Wands at the blue line, and then it's dumped in by Matro. Matro Chris Perry there, pressuring. Hands on the near board. Taken away by Niagara, up to the speed is Vecchio. Vecchio tries to get around top. Vecchio with a backhand, goes off the crossbar. Hits the netting, so we're going to have a face-off in the Oswego State zone now. Let's get away that backhand shot. Brett Dawson loses, as you know. A taping loses that one penalty. I can't tell you that it's going to be on. That one was O'Neill, and I think that's how they are on Niagara. that's going to be a tripping call to CJ Walsh hit the ice.
Yeah,
now, only 3 seconds in.
That just called the game to go on. And the person. Skating on the far side. McNamara gets around one. Tries to get a backhand. Instead, O'Neill's going to meet him. Now at the blue line. Now on the near side with Hazel. Hazel. McNamara can't get a stick on it for the one timer at the far circuit. John O'Neill just wrapped it around. That goes around. They're sticking a Hazel in the near corner. And he's in a big defensive zone. Cleared all the way down by Niagara. Themselves looking for a point to pass to the blue line. Nick Hazel's there to pressure. He's going to make Zell hold it. Somebody come down! Gazowicz, he's going to get around Walsh, he can't, that's taken away by Chapin. Chapin tries to chip it up for himself to get some speed, but instead taking it away is Gibson Stewart. I don't know, his own net is Kyle Clifford, pass coverage gives it back to Stewart. Through a long pass, breakaway opportunity for Peters. Peters, breakaway, shot, blocked by Alex Pelosi. Stop with the pad. No final opportunity. 17:51 remaining in a series 19 on the Mississippi 23 on the Niagara penalty. 51 on the clock. That one over there. So that's going to happen again. It is such a far breakaway opportunity. Big seat by the Marshall. They're going to take that's the pad. It's going to take them for that one. John O'Neill up to Nick Mitchell. Nick Mitchell can get a stick on it. Tries to give it to Markey. Markey can't get a stick on either. So we dump back in. I bet you. And I agree. That was Sean O'Neill. O'Neill looking for a pass put away by Kopitov. Stewart is in the center. Kopitov looking to get a shot, but that's blocked away by Ray Charles. It's going to go wide. Now over to Simonek. Simonek. Over to O'Neill in the far corner. Back to Simonek. Back to some pass. Simonek. Getting himself. Gives it back to Neal. These two playing pass. O'Neill. He's up in neutral zone with Matrix. 5-on-4. This is a 5-on-5. Once he's returned to full strength. Like that one went out of the play. Now, Romano. Well, down by Pelosi after it was hit, tapped high. up, gets over to Bigfoot, and they can't even see it. So it goes right in the sink of Fish. Fish, Crawford, Fish right in the center. Fish, backhand, stop! By Golosi, Matt. Huge save by Markey. Now through Kyle, Chris Carey, excuse me, just threw it all the way down. And that one's going to be an icing. Big save there by Major, by Golosi, excuse me. Once again, Golosi can help out. There's a couple players up in front of him. He wins it into the cup. Baker can't hold on. That's going to stay in the offensive zone for Niagara right in front. Gets around one. Goes for a shot. Robert McNamara can't get the pass. That's going to be a penalty. There's going to be a hooking on Oscar Murray. He can do that. By Golosi. Hazlett to the point. Shot from Vecchio. That goes high and wide. Just hits the glass. No netting. Tried to clear away is Nathan Morgan, but it's taken away by Niagara and just dumps it back in. Now CJ Wallace at the far corner. Wallace, you know, hold on. He tries to clear it, and he does get all the way down to the neutral zone, at least the far side of the neutral zone. Now holding to Vecchio. Up to Hazlett. Hazlett wrapping it around. Over onto the stick, Gazowicz. Gazowicz can barely hold on, but he gives it over to Fish. Met by Walsh. Walsh can't get a stick on it. Now with Fish. Fish just leads over Gazowicz. And now we're going to pass up, maybe up to the blue line. Going to give it over to Hazel. Hazel is shot from the point. High, deflected wide. I don't know what the heck it looks like. Now he's moving to the far corner of Peters. Peters to Fish. Fish behind the net, looking for something up front. Backhands it, hits it from Simonek. Now we'll get Gazowicz. Peters now in the near corner. Now Gazowicz. Gazowicz at the top of the circle. Now Peters at the near boards. Into the half wall. Peters. Passes to Stockwell. We'll give it back to Peters. Now it's Gazowicz. Now it's Stockwell. Stockwell slap from the blue line. Right into the chest of Golosi. He doesn't know where it is. 63 shots against Niagara and Dwyer last year. So he knows how to, he knows what it's like to be peppered. He's been on point tonight with a shot from the point. Shot goes right in front. He's going to hold on to that shot from Gazowicz with a high shot from Stockwell. But that shot was taken away by O'Neill just at the last second. So Niagara couldn't get the puck on it. He stick on the puck. But O'Neill again, who just quickly moved his own, couldn't get a full clear. Going just barely on side. And now he'll have to go back to the neutral zone. He being Robert McNamara. Even strength now. Theo Cuss finally is over. 5-on-5 hockey. Lakers to another. Chris Wants. Wants. Gets a breakaway. Shot. Just as it says. Oh, goal! With Jake Chapin gets a rebound. It's a 2-1 game right after the power play for Niagara. Jake Chapin gets his goal. He had one yesterday as well. 2-1. Sorry, that was Kyle McNamara. I can't see the one, so he's got his second of the night. Brandon Waddle's being for nine tonight as well. Great jersey number. The great deal of fun is actually messing my eyes up. I got it sometime in the next week or so. Great. Either way, Kyle McNamara with his second of the night. It's a McNamara fest. Robert McNamara has the first Niagara goal. Kyle McNamara has both the Oswego goals. 13:55 remaining in the period. It's a 2-1 game for Oswego State. Chris Wands racing after it. No, it is going to be an icing.
Parrish was racing after Olga. Wands wins the race. 344 remaining. He's back to the single stage zone. Kyle McNamara with two goals tonight. Now he's up to 27 with 12 goals, 15 assists, and like I said, 27 points. Patrick Romano first moved off to go to Manny Lazuzzo, so he plays the body of Pop instead. Now having Lazuzzo's over the offense of himself with Joel Koenig, thinking about Watts. Watts tries to give it over to Chapin. Chapin just behind the puck, and now to Manny once again. Trying to take it away with Lemieux, and the Cubs are going to try to battle that one in the neutral line. Just offside, so players couldn't touch it from the Swedish State. Michael Lemieux now pressuring Conan. I think it wraps it around. Now to Parrish at center ice. He's going to kick it, but it's taken away by Chris Wads over the field from the far boards. Markey just taps it in. Chasing after some power back. He's out, passes it back. Clears it all the way down. That might be an icing as no Oswego State player touched it. It is Chris Wan. That was the next one there. Chris Wan has to cut it up. Niagara, and now in the neutral zone. Parrot loses it to Simonac, and now we have Markey. Markey, trying to pass, he's closing up to Terry. Terry can't get back on it. It's a little bit of a high pass from Markey, trying to get him back in rebound. He pokes away by Niagara. Patrick Romano with it. Gives it off to Markey, though. He pokes it away. He takes the skate after it. Man, gives it to Stewart. He just will play one more force now. C.J. Walsh tries to poke it away from Manny, holds on. He'll just hit the skate of Walsh. He's going to the top of the zone. Niagara Romano's backhands it to C.J. Gaswick. Now to Matro. Matro with some speed. Skating into the other zone, gives it off to Markey. Markey is bumped off the puck by Clifford. Now Gaswick's in a fight with it for Matro. That's a good Simonac. Simonac third angle shot right in front. Markey with a shot. Once again blocked by Zell. That's going to go onto the end boards. And now it's Simonac with the blue line after it's tapped up by Niagara. Wrapped all the way around to CJ Walsh. Walsh going to come in front. Markey gets a tip. Hits Zell. But he's going off a weird angle. It's going to go onto the neutral zone now. The Gazzo's going to break away. Simonac gets there. Can't get a shot. It is a shot. Can't get a stick tip. So I go high and wide. C.J. Walsh trying to clear up in the offensive zone now. About to suck it up right there. Really breakaway chance that the Niagara University has had. We'll see it stop. 2-1 high line. They speak of state. Let's stay on. The Niagara University is going to take advantage of the entire state line. At center ice, it's going to be Bobby Baskin. Facing David Fitch. 11-5 remaining in this period. Bastard wins it, gives it up to Perry, gives it back to Walsh, and then poke away. Cooper's all around. That's also going to be an icing. Walsh tried to win the race, but winning it easily was going to be Smoka. He'll go all the way back down once again. He's tired. He's been out there, this line has been out there for a while. That's it. Again, it's going to be a day. The backhand it was, but stopped by Walsh. Nathan Morgan gets there. They tried to clear up by Bobby Bassett, but he shot wide just to dump it back in. Bish. Clear pass in the slot. Instead, gives it up to the point, taking a shot with Daniel Smolka on top of it by Walsh. Now with Chris Carey. Chris Carey gets around one after a falling. Cleared all the way down. No icing. Sean O'Neill does win the race, though, and gets prepared. We're a little late to the party. Now we're in the cup. The cup is over to O'Neill.
Tries to get it up to Dawson, sorry, RJ Smith. But just out of reach for RJ Smith. It took a 10-08 now remaining. Nice. Smith State's got to stay on. He was able to change a couple of lines. So it's 2-1 at least Smith State show. After a couple of times, back here. Colts. I'll be back to Stockwell. Going to stop the Vecchio, but it was a miscued pass and now dumped in. He wanted to kind of win the race, but Hickey is going to be Romano. All the way down the ice, and he's going to be icing once again. Kyle Turner wins that one after the next game. Yes, again, there's a little bit of a lot of training. He's going to be a little bit of a game. Down by Galozzi. Now to make nature with it. He's going to backhand it to Chris Carey, but beating him there is his nine counterpart, David Pitts. That's a hot Metro. Now it's going to be a Stockwell. Stockwell. Got a man on the right. Parrish was just offside. Anthony Parrish was about a step ahead. Not even maybe a half step ahead. So we go back into the neutral zone. And the pair saw him coming, and he waited for a Oscar Markey, that's right, he wants to face off, goes back to Simmons, that goes to O'Neal. O'Neal up to Nick Matro. Matro just dumps it in. It was over the stick of Zell, no icing. This is one of the stick of Clifford. Clifford just wraps it around over to his teammate. Daniel Smolka. Clifford. Shot. Fans, no shot. Goal! No! I think he's a stop by Solos, actually. After a shot at him. The goal went off the scoring. Over to Robert McNamara. Now it's on the stick of Logan Field. Field over to Hazlett. Hazlett looking for a pass. He'll get around her bear. Hazlett looking for a shot. He takes a shot right in front of DeRossi. Goes back on the stick of Hazlett. DeRossi can hold on. Hazlett back to Thurston. Thurston back to heel the point. Goes wide. DeRossi didn't even touch that one with his club. Now it's a field with near force. Field. Looking for a pass. Glove down by Wands. Wants him to get around the field, and he's going to try to get around Hazlett, but he can't hold on. Bobby Bashman gets second half of the bear, just dumps it in. And now racing to that one, Nick Morgan is going to be taken away by Robert Mack. No offside there. Chris Martin just dumps it into the neutral zone. Give me no icing as it didn't go far enough. Hazlett just leaves it for Thurston. Thurston has central ice, center ice, I should say. Chris Wands just uses the puck. No icing. DeRossi touches it. Now it's Theo Cup. Theo Cup wraps around for Nate Morgan. Morgan looks for a backhand, but he's just tipping to himself. That goes up. He's been now on the stick of Gazowitz. Cup hits him, so he's pumped up the puck. Now it's taping. That goes on the stick now. Niagara, that one is stick of Vecchio. Chapin fell and goes over him with Robert McNamara. Now to Theo Cup. Cup using icing as he's hit off the puck by Gazowitz. He goes all the way down. No Oswego State player to touch it. And now with 4:27 remaining in the period, Oswego State still leads 2-1 to go back to the zone with another icing ball. Oswego State may be losing a little momentum here at the end of this period after scoring the second half. Chapin along with Gazowitz. Gazowitz that one shot. Walked away by Colosi, that shot looks like it came from Vecchio. Taking it with Bobby Vasco, and Nate Morgan tries to back it up from the center and fight for him. Bobby Vasco just comes down so he can't climb with the nice. Bring the small back, goes up to Mark Center, next Mark Center goes up, shoots it down, just goes over the glove of reaching Zell. Now the shot from Chapin, CJ Walsh. That's padded with easy as well. Walsh will just dump it in. He goes over to the defender. No icing as he gained his red line. That's only that'll be with Patrick Lamato who leaves it. Or Ryan Peters that just went ahead. Now it's a Michael Lee after a turn. Michael Lee's shot. It just goes wide after it might have been tipped. Michael Lee just dumps back. No player there to meet him. CJ Walsh now back. Backwards to try to meet his man. No icing. Mark Simmons there with Peters. Simmons and Peters going after it. Going to the bird along with Chapin. Lemieux in there along with Fish now. It's frozen there. No one's taking the puck. Chapin and Fish are going at it. Now so on Walsh's stick, Walsh tried to go for a baseball player and move there, but now it's on to his stick. McNamara had two goals tonight. McNamara, Mew on his right. McNamara tries to go to Mew. He gains in there. Markey trying to get his stick on it, but his stick is tied up. Now goes all the way down to the zone for Simonek. Simonek with McNamara gets a check, cross check to pick it. So he's able to play. Pitch was down, but it's now retired in person. On the stick of fish, Kyle McNamara keeps an eye on himself. Oscar Martin, McNamara gives him another bluff hit. And now it's going to be Walsh giving up to Smolin. Well, actually, dumps it in. It's going to pick up O'Neill. O'Neill up to Pedro. Pedro puts him on that. Terry. Chris or CJ Walsh. CJ Walsh over to Kyle McNamara. CJ Walsh can't get a stick out of his stick. It's lifted. Chris Timmons wants an interference call. Can't get anything on that one, though. It's going to be an icing, though. It's Sean O'Neill brings that one. Goes all the way down the ice. Back to the Niagara zone, 2:15 remaining in the period, 2-1 Lakers. Timmons not happy with that call. I don't want to start calling the interference, maybe he was flat. Either way, no dice. Now it's going to be an Oscar Martin in the center, along with Daniel Smolin. Paul Crawford, Justin Crawford. Neil Tuck dumps it in under the stick of Kyle McNamara. Now it's going to go on the stick of Agent Parrish racing with his feet on the far side. Parrish can't get a shot off. Protector puck on the back. Now it's Sean O'Neill's going to take that. Crawford right on him. And from Parrish, blocked away. Panda went back to those big rebound. Crawford wasn't there in time. Mitchell knocks Crawford off the puck. Now it's with Markey. Back up to the stick of Mitchell. Mitchell tries to get over to Chris Carey. He does. Gets him over the head. Parrish. Parrish got one man to beat. He tries to get a rally one. He can't. Just dumps it. Markey just wraps it around on the second carry. Carry goes for a pass. He gives it all the way over to Nick Matro. Nick Matro spins around his man. Gives it to Stewart. Shot up. Matro just dumps it in for Markey. Markey does something. He's going to try to fight for it. Now it's going to lose to Matro. Markey second pushes it up to the center for Parrish. Takes it away. Parrish wraps it around. Niagara versus the Italian takes some possession, but they take, dump it, gives me into the neutral zone. Now it's O'Neill. Just dumps it in. Bobby Bastard falls. Now it's in the neutral zone with Robert McNamara. McNamara getting it headed around, patted away, gloved down by Colosi. He'll hold onto it. Bobby Vasta giving a late hit by Tyler Stockwell, and they share a couple hits with each other. Bobby Vasta is pulled away by a teammate. By his teammate, Liam Tuttle. 47.9 seconds remaining in this one. Here it is, I can say. They will take it in their mind. Nate Morgan skating on the other side. Bobby Vasta. Chapin at the center. One by Chapin, just by a pair. That's going to be Chris Watson just jumping up. It's going to be an icing. No icing, actually. McNamara was close enough. 37 now remaining in the period. Chris Watson on the line. Chris Watson in the shot. Fans on L. Chapin came right in front. Now McNamara just a rebound. This goes high into the netting.
And welcome back to the third regulation period for Oswego State ACHA Hockey versus Niagara University. And Oswego State's taking this one a little bit 3-1 so far, heading into the final regulation frame. Kyle McNamara has both goals, the first two goals for Oswego State. Jay Chapin has the third, and Robert McNamara has the only goal for Niagara at the moment. So, just for an update, I'm doing the math correctly. We all know as a journalism broadcasting major, I'm not that great at getting a whole math in my head. We can see players there. Even Herbert there. So, if I'm doing the math correctly anyway, Kyle McNamara now has 27 points, 12 goals, and 15 assists. Jay Chapin has 4 points with 3 goals, 1 assist, and 4 points. And Robert McNamara, Niagara, has 23 points, 15 goals, and 8 assists. About 40 seconds remaining on that clock. We're going to get ready to come out. Niagara not out yet. Because they will most likely be in the next break. Niagara trying to maybe get some little motivation to try to overcome this 2-goal deficit. All the Oswego State is out. Alex Golosi will be waiting at the bench for the referees and also for the Niagara team. The coaches are out for both teams. Apologize for my little hiccup there. As you can tell, it's been a crazy weekend for me at least. Between yesterday at the ECC game, where I was unfortunately not able to broadcasting, as I said, that was a late night and early morning, making sure we got out of the studio around 10 a.m. and we got to the game around 1 o'clock, so we had a couple hours of the game. We were like, tries to get up the fish, but it goes off his skate instead, and just backhanded across ice to Hazel. Hazel's going to go in the near corner up to fish once again. Fish tries to get up to Crawford, but it's off to Cup. Cup just over, turns it over to the fish, which just dumps it in. That was Wands. Wands wraps it around up to Lemieux. Lemieux looks for a pass in right into the skates of Andrew Perry. Chris Wands now with it in his own zone. Tries to get up to Kyle McNamara. That one's cut off. But David Fish, he's going to wrap it around onto the stick of Parrish. He tries to get into Crawford, but can't get the first pick. And now he's shot from a point from Smolak. And it's a rebound goal for Crawford. Right over to Golosi. This is a one-goal game now. 3-2, 19-17 remaining in the regulation period. Niagara cuts the lead in half. Crawford gets the rebound goal. That is his eighth of the season, his 28th point on the season. We'll have that set right. 43 seconds in, just like that. He's cut in half. The Smolak will come. Smolak smoke a shot. And then Crawford bumped it over to head of the race for a big save there. By Zell.
to feed this one the one goal game. I was looking at my notes there for the pause. There's some correction I might have. And now Nick Matro. Matro loses it though. Now it's up at the point. Now it is with Markey with some speed. Markey with carry. Markey takes a shot. Blocker. Carry looking for the rebound. Can't get a stick on it. Now he's racing up the ice with Robert McNamara. McNamara gets around one. He tries to get around two, but leaves a pass off. That's taken by Nick Matro. Matro is going to pick it off the boards of Carey. Carey's going to take it. He's going to try to get a split in between. Carey tries to take the shot right into the chest of Zell. Zell is going to hold on to it with Matro pressuring. So apparently I was way wrong. The assist came from Fish and Parrish, not even from Spolter, so I don't know what I was looking at. But either way, 3-2 still. Niagara University there with a 2-on-1, trying to get a shot off, but nothing right in the slot. It's going to be taken away by Marcellic. Marcellic just dumps it into the neutral zone. It's going to be taken by Gazowicz, but Marcellic recovers it. Marcellic back to Cup. Cup looks for a long pass. Instead, gives it to Dawson. Dawson in the neutral zone. He's bumped off the puck. Now it's with Herbert. Guillaume Herbert loses the puck if he's bumped off. Bumped off the puck, at least by Gibson Stewart. Now it's with Vecchio. Vecchio just backhands. Brett Arson can't get a stick on it. So dumping it is going to be Theo Cup. Romano. Brett Dawson. Now it's on the stick of Gibson Stewart again, who just tried to give it to Gazowicz. But Theo Cup grabs the puck up there. Just hit Gazowicz. Now it's going to be opportunity for Gazowicz. Gazowicz. Shot. Goes wide. That's going to be a Stewart. Stewart bumped off the puck right in the slot. Now with it is Basta. Basta with some speed. He'll just dump it in. He's going to chase after himself. Zell holds on to it. Bounce off the board. Now with Vecchio into the neutral zone with CJ Walsh. Walsh had a breakaway opportunity earlier. Holding on to it is Patrick Romano. A shot there from Nate Morgan after RJ Smith lost it a little bit. Noah Koenig just wrapped it around. Shot from the point came. Looks like that might have been. I can't tell who that is. That might be Chris Mons. It is Chris Mons and Zell can hold on to it with a couple players in front. 17:01 remaining now in the period. 3-2, Oswego State. Oswego State looking to sweep the weekend, the first Buffalo weekend. Next weekend they will be back in Buffalo, same hotel, same area. Unfortunately, I won't be here. But they will be back in Buffalo with a game against University at Buffalo and Canisius College, both NECHL games. Niagara University holding on to it now at the end boards. Now it's with Chris Carey. Your corner. Right up in front. Glossy didn't see it. So behind the boards. Chris Wan's fighting for it. RJ Smith now there. Now it's in the neutral zone as Steele can hold on to it. Now that Chris wants some speed. Chris Wan gets around field and he just loses the puck. The field is spun around by RJ Smith. Now it's taken away by Fish. Fish is going to have a 3-on-2. He's going to lead it. And he's going to have his own opportunity just to fly that for Eddie Pelosi. Keeping it a 3-2 game. Able to control some of the rebound. Fish looking for a shot, but that goes wide. Kind of a weaker rebound, or a weaker change-up shot, I should say. Now with Bobby Basta. Basta tries to poke it away, but it goes into the Oswego State bench. Excuse me, no, next weekend, actually, they are at Slippery Rock University in Pennsylvania, both January 25th and January 26th. That's their next weekend. That is not an NACHL weekend. But the weekend after, February 2nd, February 3rd, between RIT and Cortland, those are the NACHL weekend. And then they have University at Buffalo Community College on the 8th and 9th. And then we'll be back home the 17th and the 24th, which is Cortland and Niagara. O'Neill will win the race for no, actually, icing. It is waved off.
That's actually the action.
That's why we have a camera here. Now it's going to be with Clifford. Clifford leaves it off for Stockwell. It's taken away by McNamara. McNamara can't clear the zone. A little high, but doesn't hit the netting. O'Neill now, Pelosi will just hold on right in front. And he starts to get the ring. I'm going to go to the hospital.
case. In case. I'm going to throw in a towel for you, making sure you get the last word. Off the master blocker, shoulder before we see him go down. Now the McNamara. McNamara looking for a shot. He's interfered with a little bit. No call, and there's the whistle. Actually, it's going to be offside. All the way to really delayed offside. Here, not on the right side of the field. So it was offside after the paper was onto him. So I guess that was why it was delayed all through. Clearing all the way down the ice. So it's going on to stick at Clifford. That was, looks like that was going near Clifford all the way down. Now it's on the stick of Peters. Peters can hold on. Chris Carey just taps it. And it's going to go right in the glove of Zell, who just sticks it away. Marky Berry playing a hit onto David Smolka. Chris Mons can't get a stick on it. It's going to go all the way down. Now with Theo Cup. Cup at the end boards waiting for it. Looking for someone to pass to. Tries to, does give it to Carey. Carey will just tip it in his offensive zone. 14:30 remaining in the period. Fish hold on. He gives it over to Romano. Romano just clears all the way down. No icing. There is an icing. Actually, Theo Cup wins that one. Niagara wants that one back. Actually, this is going to be a no icing. Because you know it is going to be an icing. Niagara not happy about that one. The linesman even looks a little confused as well. He's going to go to the near circle. Niagara head coach Larry Petrowski does not want that one. He's going up in zone, but Jake Chambers is going to take the draw with David Fish right there on him. That one's taken by Chapin. Chapin looking for a backhand. Instead, just throws it, but it's blocked away by a couple of Niagara defensemen. None of them are close to Zell. Backhanded, but that one's blocked away by Gibson Stewart. Stewart on the Chapin, on with Peters and Fish. Mike Lemieux waiting for a bump out. Couldn't get it. That's going to be taken away by Stewart. Romano gives it back to Stewart, and that one goes up to Vecchio. Vecchio skating up with speed in the center. Vecchio can't get around one and stick away. Mike Lemieux will hold the puck. He's going to see it with some speed himself. Mike Lemieux tries the backhand. He puts it right into the glove of Romano. He's being looking for a backhand under the stick of Chapin, but couldn't get it close enough. Shot in! Tie game! Angel Parrish with a shot from the faceoff dot. That one just gets past Pelosi. It is a 3-3 game. 13:39 remaining in the period. The Lakers have been missing with a 2-goal lead, and now they've seen that lead vanish. They saw it vanish early in the period. Now they've seen it vanish with 13:39 remaining. Niagara University takes this one and ties this one, I should say. That's an Andrew Parrish goal past Pelosi. Looks like it might have gone 5-1 to Dwyer, but it's a match. Seager State wins the faceoff. Now it's just CJ Walsh. Walsh off to Guillaume Herbert. Herbert just dumps it into the corner. Zell, hold on. Stick it away and try to get a pass off. Going all the way down, and that's going to be an icing now. Simic will win that one easily. 13:25 remaining. And it's going to go into the neutral, into the offensive zone of the Seager State. Niagara must stay on. They can't change after the icing. Good to be at the near circle. Guillaume Herbert at center, along with Tyler Stockwell. Stockwell wins that one back to Hazlett. Now wrap all the way up to Robert McNamara. McNamara leaves it for Stockwell. Stockwell leaves it for himself. He'll tip it off over to McNamara. McNamara over to... Excuse me, over to Thurston, but couldn't get a shot off. That just went wide. Dawson tries to tip it up. Can't get anything there. Now it's Guillaume Herbert. Herbert is backward skating a little bit. Should have got, tried to get some speed. He slides it over to Nate Morgan. Morgan looking for a weird angle shot. Tries to get it in front, but no one was home to knock it in. Nate Morgan. Morgan just tips it. Now going to stick at Dawson. Dawson looking for a pass to skate around. tosses this back, hands it, wraps it back around, but that goes right into the thick of Tyler Stockwell. Down the neutral zone, Cup. Cup will just dump it in offside, but Nate Morgan skates back on. Oswego State changes. 12:30 remaining. Field. Field will wrap it around. He's knocked down by Chris Carey. No call there. Maybe he looked a little high. By the way, he'll go into the offensive zone. Now it's Gasolik. Gasolik for that shot, but that's walked away by Galosi. That's with Chris Carey, who gives it up to Nick Matro. Nick Matro loses it. He's speeding after it. Gets it. He's bumped off the puck by Smolka. He's knocked down. No call there. Now taken away by David Hazlett, who will just dump it all the way down. Which is now Markey couldn't hold on to it. Now taken away by Gazowicz. Gazowicz looking to maybe get something in close. Markey right there on him, though. Couldn't get anything strong. And it just goes high after it was tipped high over the head of Galosi. Niagara building on some momentum here, maybe trying to take the lead. It'd be the first lead since Robert McNamara scored the opening goal for the Purple Eagles. Chris Carey loses it. He just dumped it into the zone for Markey. Markey tries to backhand it over to O'Neill. Not strong enough. Now with Vecchio. Vecchio looking for a shot. He loses it after a couple of pokes. And now, shot from Fish. And that's blocked up in front by Markey. Nick Matro just dumping into the neutral zone. Gloved down by Clifford. Fish just tips it in to avoid the icing. Now it's a Theo Cup. He's going to give it over to his teammate, Chris Wands. And now it's in the neutral zone. Nick Matro. Nick Matro just dumps it against the red line. No teammate that'll help him, but racing up to it is Kyle McNamara. He's got two goals tonight for Oswego State. Kyle McNamara pressuring. Now right in the neutral zone, taken away by CJ Walsh. CJ Walsh can't hold onto it firmly, though. He knocks down his man, Ancient Parish. CJ Walsh has it on the end boards. He's going to bank it up. They try to bank up the Chapin. Chapin can't hold on. That's with Parish again. And now it's taken away by Chapin. Chapin can't win the race. Almost next away, I should say. Now it's CJ Walsh. Walsh up to Crawford. Crawford just tips it in. Couldn't get a ton of force on that one. Now it's Chapin. Chapin getting up with some speed, but he loses it to Patrick Romano. Romano just dumps it in. And they'll go behind into Glow, so I just say into the glove. It was 10-13 left in the period. Lakers lead, or Lakers are tied with Niagara University 3-3. We thank you for joining us on YouTube Live for Oswego State ACHA Hockey. I'm Mangrico. We're at Dwyer Ice Arena at Niagara University. Oswego State coming off the 7-3 win. That goes wide, doesn't hit Galosi. This is up front now, and they're coming up the 7-3 win to the ECC. That one just goes wide. Now with McNamara after a dump it from center. Michael Mew behind the net, couldn't get anything up there. It's Simonet. Chapin at the blue line, looking for a shot, rips it. Right in front, McNamara scores! Kyle McNamara gets the go-ahead goal. Now he gets the hat trick. That's two straight games with a Oswego State player with a hat trick. Kyle McNamara gets the rebound up in front. I don't know if Zell can touch that, but with 9:46 remaining, Oswego State takes this lead 4-3. Kyle McNamara gets the hat trick tonight. He had three assists last night, and he has three goals tonight. 6 points in two games for McNamara. He has 3/4 of the goals tonight for Oswego State. He's got 3 of 7 in the game tonight. Niagara wins that one. Now with David Hazlett. They try to pass it up. That's cut away by Markey. Markey just dumps it in. So we try to get with Matro. Markey now tries to get up to Matro. Onto the end boards. Markey wasn't right there. Wands keeps it in. He'll just dump it in, but it's gloved down by Field. Field will race up his speed on the far board. And now it's poked away into the neutral zone. Markey will be the first one there, and he'll just dump it in. Hazlett on the near board. He's checked by Markey and falls down. He goes in the neutral zone. Nate Morgan tried to keep it in. Hazlett just blows it down. Markey had to return to neutral zone, but he's made it back in. Stop by Wands. Wands almost offside. He is offside. Markey questioning that one just about an inch over. Timmons telling Markey, say, it's okay. You were offside for sure. Just about a step over, maybe, as Markey trying to skate over. Chris Wands is trying to get into the offensive zone, but it was offside. 8:58 remaining in the regulation period. Oswego State regains the lead 4-3 after allowing two goals throughout the opening 10 minutes.
Now that's with Clifford. Clifford just dumps it in. Mostly he'll stick it away and pass it off. That's if we take it away by Fishtail. Back to Clifford. Clifford fans a shot at the point. And that's with Simonek up to Morgan. Morgan in the neutral zone. That just goes offside. RJ Smith is the culprit. Just a step ahead as he's knocked a little late by Clifford with a little love tap there with the shoulder. Now there's 8:42 left. Back into the neutral zone. Towards the Niagara offensive zone on the far dot. Bobby Bassa still at center along with Andrew David Fish. David Fish that when David Fish wins that one cleanly right in the stick of Bell. No Niagara Purple Eagle was there. It's at the red line and near boards now. Cleared all the way out is Walsh into the offensive zone. At first, Oswego State, but Niagara will take it. Nate Morgan can't hold on to it, so he's going to go back to the neutral zone. Now taken away by Crawford. Crawford gets around one. He's tripped up a little bit. No call. There is a call. Actually, it could be on Niagara or on Oswego. Delph got just an eventual a little bit blown. Interference call. Let's see what that was on. It looks like it's going to be on Nate Morgan. Potentially to stop the breakaway there. 8:19 remaining. If Oswego State will hit the penalty kill again, tonight they are 4-4 on Pelican. Dawson, Cup, Herbert, and O'Neill out there for the first unit. Pelosi maintaining his net. Cup right there trying to play the puck. Falls down instead. Niagara University hold on to it at the blue line with Field. Field maybe looks for a shot, except he fans on a attempted pass, maybe a fake pass there. As Cup's there to meet the man in the far near corner. How about that one? Now at the blue line, Field. Field looking for a shot. He gets turned away, though. Now takes a fake shot. Faked me out, even. Now with Field. He's getting around with it a lot. Now with Crawford. Crawford back there with Field. Field at the near circle. Maybe looking for a pass. Gives up to Crawford instead. And now gives up to Field. Quarterback is on the blue line. Now Crawford. Crawford takes almost a shot. Now in the near post. The shot from Robert McNamara. That was easily blocked away by Galosi. Cut for the Field. Point! Field! Ties this one up. Laser of a slap shot. This one's side on the power play. It looks like Galosi was green on that one. 7:24 remaining. That's going to be Field's sixth of the season, his 13th point. He takes a laser slap shot from the point. Quarterbacking that one. He had the puck alive, that one. That sort of power play. Niagara University ties this one 4-4 with 7:24 left in the period. CJ Walsh now just dumps into the neutral zone, taken away by Niagara University, but he'll get it back. Up to Carey. Carey tries to get around one. He can't, but it's almost taken away by Markey. Markey offside. Now he's not. He grabs the puck. He gets around one. He gets around two. And now it's Chris Carey. Carey at the far corner looking for a pass. Instead, Markey takes it. He'll just make the safe pass to Walsh, but loses it into the neutral zone. He can't hold on to it. They'll just dump it in right into the chest of Zell, who hold on to it as Chris Carey was pressuring. With 6:51 remaining, we have a tie game again, 4-4. As you can see, losing his lead once again for the second time this period. Gazowicz, along with Markey in center, Gazowicz wins, actually, really just tied up his end! Chris Carey hits Zell, goes off him, and gets him in a weird corner. 6:48 remaining. Oswego State once again takes the lead. And that was really a bad bounce on Zell. He's taking that one. He just slaps the stick on the corner board. He wasn't happy with himself on that. He's still slapping the stick on the post. Looks like it might hit the shoulder and just bounce over. I'll have to watch the replay after the game and look for that one. So 6:48 remaining. 20 shots later, Oswego State has a 5-4 lead. And that is Chris Carey's sixth of the season. So he's got 11 points now. Vitro can't hold onto it, so it's into the offensive zone for Niagara behind the net. Holding onto it, it looks like Vitro himself again. Chris Carey with it, skating around one, can't get around Vetrio completely, so he'll get pinned up in the near corner. Vitro there to help him out. He'll hold onto it. He gets around his man and tries to give it back to Markey, but gives it back to Carey instead of Markey couldn't get a stick on it. Vitro with it, makes it a safe pass to O'Neill. O'Neill, slap shot. Hits the pads. Markey trying to get a rebound shot off.
And it looks like O'Neill's going to have it in the neutral zone. O'Neill gives it up to Matro. Matro looking for Markey. He'll just up it into the far corner. Instead, Markey will just wrap it around. Stewart just backhands it up to Vecchio. He gives it to Parrish, who gives it over to Fish. Fish looking for a shot. Blocked away by Colosi easily. This one's going to be taken away by Niagara. Markey couldn't win the race. And that one's taken away by Hazlett. Hazlett, far pass. No icing as it's tipped. Parrish will take that one in the near corner in their offensive zone. Juan's there to meet him, though. Couldn't hold on to the puck. Back at the blue line, over to Hazlett. Hazlett, shot blocked up in front by Juan. No, by Chapin, excuse me. McNamara's got it. He might look for four. McNamara looking for Lemieux. Can't get it. Blocked pass by Hazlett as he's sort of diving down to stop that one. Mike Lemieux is streaking down the ice, maybe looking for his fifth or fourth goal in two games. Theo Cup. When it loses it, he gives it up to Fish. Fish back at the blue line, can't hold on to it. It's fielded out to breakaway once again from McNamara. McNamara shot, patted away by Zell. And he'll hold on to that one. McNamara looking for number four. Couldn't get the five hole of Zell. 4:56 remaining in this one. As people say, it still be 5-1 after a couple more takers. A couple breakaways by Kyle McNamara. Maybe like a deal in that first one. Takes his own shot at this one, but can't get it past Zell. Bobby Vassell wins out. We'll give it to RJ Smith, who gives it back to Simonek, who dumps it in. That's going to go into the neutral zone. CJ Walsh grabs it. Niagara dumped it in herself. Offside, but it's onside after Oswego State now recovers. Smolka gives over to Hazlett. Hazlett, long pass. It goes right into the pass to CJ Walsh. Now to Bobby Vasta. Vasta back to CJ Walsh. Walsh gives it up to Nate Morgan. He tips it to Bobby Vasta, who just dumps it in himself. And Zell will attempt to get a stick on it. And Morgan's right there to meet the Niagara player, Kyle Clifford. Neutral zone now. Now have Robert McNamara, Niagara. He's in the neutral zone. Gets around Morgan. He leaves it off for Clifford. Tries to leave it up front for Anthony Thurston, but Thurston can get a stick on it. Glossy just gloves that one down, holds it, hits the stick. 4:06 remaining. Glossy will hold on with Thurston pressuring him. Oswego State still leads 5-4. And you've tuned into a fast game, but a quick game and an interesting game. Oswego State's lost its lead a couple times in this third period. They trailed in the first period 1-0. They tied it. Kyle McNamara, the first goal, he put the second goal in the second period along with Jay Chapin for a 3-1 lead. And then Niagara scored two back-to-back goals to take the 3-3 tie. Then it was a goal from Kyle McNamara. Gets the hat trick. His fourth. Yeah, we get the team's fourth, I should say, for the lead. Niagara scores again, and then all of a sudden Chris Carey gets a weird bounce goal. So that's our score right now, 5-4. Niagara neutral and blocked away by Colosi. Check down is Markey. No call there. Fans want one. Looks like he might have cross-checked him a little bit low. No call from the officials. Markey now with it. He's just going to hit in the neutral zone, try to get out the Matro. Niagara will just hit it back down with 3:20 remaining in the period. Colosi will hold on to it. Just stick it back to the defenseman. Now with Cup. Cup over to Matro. Matro can't get a firm pass on it. He'll just tip it in. Pass for Mono. He'll skate after himself. Matro into the corner. Leaves it for Chapin. Back to Matro. Matro can't get a stick on it. And he's knocked away by Gibson Stewart. A couple of the players right there. Kyle McNamara, one of them, can't get it. Now with Chapin. Chapin gives out to McNamara. McNamara looks for a backhand. Flatted away by Zell. Chapin was right there for the rebound. Couldn't get a stick on it. Proper there. Trying to get another one. Can't get around either of them. He can't get it back and off now with McNamara. McNamara with end boards, taken away by Niagara. With the end boards with Walsh. Walsh, he's knocked down hard. You don't see that often. He's a big guy and he can't get knocked down easily. But every time he does, can't exactly see if he knocked him down. Jay Chapin fighting for it. With it is Michael Lemieux. Now with Wands all the way over to Kyle McNamara. McNamara gets a Lemieux in the slot. Lemieux looking for a backhand. Gets it off the end of the post, maybe off the blocker of Zell. Now it's shaping up front. Can't get a shot. It's sticked away and tries to hit the arm in, maybe. Couldn't get it into the net either. A couple more opportunities there. We have 2 minutes now remaining in the regulation period. Oswego State leading this one 5-4. Martin Simek loses the puck, and now shot attempt away by Galosi was Anthony Thurston. Agra holding on to this one. Martin Simonek knocks his man off the puck, and he'll hold on. Simonek all the way up to McNamara. McNamara with a breakaway just ahead of him, though. Couldn't get the puck stick on the puck. And McNamara and Clifford going at it just a little bit. Markey now turns it over. He might be looking for McNamara. McNamara takes it away. He's looking for a weird angle shot, except he'll just wrap around. Gets it right in front. Markey wasn't there as much as he wanted to be. Matro with it now on Markey. Markey up front. Blocked away. Great block there. It looks like he's hurt. He's slow to get up. He's limping away, and he is being run from McNamara. McNamara's limping off after a great sacrificial block. Simonek. Simonek tries to get up to Carey. Carey loses the puck, and Niagara dumps it back in. Now with 1 minute remaining in regulation, Zell has been pulled. Now with Niagara University, 6-on-5 man advantage. Markey, shot right to slot, blocked away up front. That shot came from Tyler Stockwell. Crawford now with it. Hit by Simonek. Crawford with it, holding on. He's looking for a pass up front. Instead, take it away. Cleared all the way down. Will that go in? It's getting down. It's going to be an icing. Just wide. And it looks like Chris Timmons does want to call a timeout, potentially. It is going to be no time. It is going to be a timeout.
No, maybe.
It is going to be a timeout for Oswego State, discussing how they want to attack this last 40-28 seconds on defense. 6-on-5, Niagara pulled their goaltender with about a minute 5 left. Seagull State leads this one 5-4, despite calling it the shot total is 23-35. Niagara leads that one.
Seagull State 40.8 seconds away from potentially sweeping the weekend of the winning of ECC. Kyle McNamara with a hat trick tonight. Mike Review with a hat trick yesterday. Mark D at front, or at center, excuse me. And it looks like now Niagara is calling the timeout. They've been trying to get a game plan themselves. It looks like they're trying to get a little more rest out of it. Niagara's going to call a timeout themselves now. With that 40.8 still looming on the clock. Well, if I'm Chris Timmons right now, you got to think, I would be saying, hey, we have the lead. Just keep blocking. Maybe get something new to zone for the empty net goal. This would be the second straight game with that empty net goal. A lot closer game this time, obviously. By Niagara, I'm saying get everything on net. Get some stuff up front, try to get some tips past Pelosi. Yes, it's been strong tonight, but it's a couple of saves. I'll see a massive Niagara, 40.8 remaining. Give me a rise in a minute. In center, Ace Gaines with Ezowitz. O'Neill has it. He's going to wrap it around. Taken away by Niagara, though. In front of Vecchio. O'Neill has it. Moves his own. He can't hold on. It's tipped away. He misses the empty net opportunity. Taken away by Robert McNamara. 25 seconds on remaining. Chris Carey pressuring a lot. Oscar Markey now pressuring. He can't get a stick on it. Try to get it away from David Hazlett. Hazlett just getting around, gets past Chris Carey. Markey now on him, and now should be Walsh. Mosley hold on. Can't hold on completely. O'Neill tries to clear right in front. Mosley holds it. No, there's a whistle. There's some shoving right there. It's going to be a last second shove. 3.4 seconds remaining. Walsh going at it. With a Niagara player, I can't see his number. I think that might be Handler Dazzler. No goal, though. He got up in front. The state with 3.4 seconds left. That was a close call, but he still brought on to their 5-4 lead. All five players ready for this one. Four of them. This would put Oswego State 1 point ahead by average if it was 7 points. I'm not sure about the team taking a point ahead of the RIP.
On my mate, so he just pulls out, and that'll do it. That's the final horn. Oswego State wins this one 5-4. The last couple seconds, a really tough chance there by Niagara, but Oscar Markey was able to tie him up and hold him off, and that'll end it. Oswego State sweeps the weekend, gained 3 points in the NECHL, now has 13 points on the season. And Oswego State wins this one 5-4. That'll do it for us at Dwyer Ice Arena. Oswego, once again, Oswego State 5, Niagara University 4. Lakers sweep the weekend, highlighted by a Mike Lemieux hat trick on Saturday and a Kyle McNamara hat trick on Sunday. I'm Ben Grieco for the ACHA hockey team. We'll be back in a couple weeks. Hopefully in a couple weeks, in the beginning of February, while this team takes a little longer of a road trip, and the Lakers take this one once again, 5-4. Thanks for tuning in on YouTube Live. I'm Ben Grieco, saying so long till February.